Hi, I'm Rod. Welcome to my channel. Today I am going to be listening to Screaming Jets perform Helping Hand. This is their official music video. So let's get straight into it. This is a great song. The Screaming Jets are a great live band. They're a band I've seen numerous times and always put on a great show. Really liking that bass and the drums. The drums are just doing what's needed. I think good drummers know what this song needs. Take the time to think. So that was Helping Hand by Screaming Jets. Screaming Jets are another one of the great pub rock bands. They came from Newcastle, but once they started to make it big here in Australia, they relocated to Sydney, and some of their concerts became quite violent. Which seemed like it was fans trying to claim ownership over the band, and the Sydney fans fighting with the Newcastle fans. All quite pointless, really, but I guess that's what happens. Nice bit of trumpet in there. Guitar solo, all the instruments were good. I really liked the bass. This is an interesting song. The lyrics are interesting. I'll just go over them before I give a little background to the band. So the lyrics are, it starts off, rock on. And you've got the first verse. Sometimes things get a little hazy. Sometimes I think I'm just a little crazy. I don't even know my own name. Soon all of me will go up in flames. Yeah. And to me, this is the narrator saying that he's confused and he's disconnected from other people around him. The second verse, wearing scars on my arms and in my eyes. Are you friends or enemies in disguise? So hard when everything just runs against me. Jealous words turn into a love-hate frenzy. So here I think that the narrator is expressing his difficulty in having relationships with other people and not knowing if people are working with him or against him. Then you've got the chorus one, won't someone please understand? Won't someone lend me a helping hand? And here I think the narrator is asking for someone to listen and understand what he is saying. Asking for help to understand the relationships that he's in, which he clearly doesn't understand what's going on in them. If people are really his friends or just pretending to be. Verse 3, time is up to do the time that's left undone. It's time to grab my hat, grab my coat, I've got to load my gun. Silly things always are the ones that turn out worst, and it seems the ones who love you always hurt you the most. So here I think the narrator's expressing an urgency to get help and to get an understanding of the relationships he's in. He notes the little silly things are the ones that cause us the most anguish and frustration. Which when I look around people around me, I often see that it's just the little things that get people so upset. I often wonder whether that's why we can't have discussions about the big issues, because we're so bogged down in the little things and getting upset about them. And then he goes on to say it's the ones who love us most that cause us the most pain, which again I think is true, because you know, it doesn't really matter what those people that aren't loved ones think or say. Um, my way of thinking is that I'm not going to give those people control over my life. So I'm not going to give them the satisfaction of getting upset and whether they don't like me or they call me names or whatever. Then you go on to chorus one, won't someone please understand, won't someone lend me a helping hand. Chorus two, won't someone please take the time to think, your action and words, they don't always say what they mean. No, they don't always. So here I think the narrator is asking people to say what they mean. You know, in this world of Jordan Peterson type metaphors and political style slogans, I wish people would say what they mean too. It seems like nobody is saying what they mean. They're either talking in these Jordan Peterson type metaphors or these political slogans, which people don't really even seem to throw to understand these slogans that they throw around. And people like Jordan Peterson with their metaphors, it's just a way of them, of you not being able to hold them to account. When if you try and question them, they just say, well, that's not what I meant. When you ask them what they meant, they don't answer. So I'm with the narrator here. It's time people started saying what they mean. Life would be so much easier and you could hold people to account if they just said what they mean. Then you've got the post-chorus, rock on. Wah wah, yeah, yeah, yeah. Verse 4, since I was a child, I used to dream of many things. Superstars, the bizarre, kings and their pretty queens. Now it seems that I need a shot, a drink to jog my thoughts. Why does this happen all the time? Is it just because? So here I think the narrator is saying as a child he had a vivid imagination, and now as an adult that is gone. And he needs something like alcohol to kick his thoughts off. Chorus 3, because no one will understand. No, no, no. Someone lend me a helping hand. Chorus 2, wah, wah, yeah. Won't someone please take the time to think that your actions and words, they don't always say what they mean. They don't always say, why won't somebody say what they mean? Well, yeah. So it ends, at least in my mind, with the narrator frustrated because he's asking for honesty and clarity, but feels people are still not saying what they really mean. So to me, that was quite good writing, which brings up some serious issues, especially what's going on with the culture wars today, and how the far left and the far right have just completely hijacked any kind of rational political talk. But anyway, a bit about the Screaming Jets. The Screaming Jets, an Australian hard rock band formed in Newcastle, Australia in 1989 by frontman Dave Gleeson on vocals, Paul Woseen, bass guitar, Grant Walmsley, guitar, Richard Lara, guitar, and Brad Heaney, drums. The band has three albums that peaked in the top five on the ARIA Albums Chart, All For One from 1991, Tear of Thought from 1992 and The Screaming Jets from 1995. Their 1991 single Better reached number 4 on the related singles charts. Walmsley left in 2007 and formed his own band. In 2013, bassist Paul Woseen released an acoustic album. That was a solo album, Bombido. The Screaming Jets are still active today. Paul Woseen died a couple of months ago, so I'm not really sure of the status of the Screaming Jets, whether they are still playing. Dave Gleeson is also the singer and has been for quite a number of years now of another great Australian pub rock band, The Angels. So yeah, Paul Woseen was a big part of the Screaming Jets, so that will have a big effect on the band. Tear of Thought is their second studio album, released in October 1992 on the Rue Art label. It was produced by Steve James. Tear of Thought debuted at number 20 in Australia in November 1992 and peaked at number 3 in June 1994. Jonathan Lewis of AllMusic gave the album 3 out of 5, saying, "Screaming Jets return in 1992 with their second full-length album. Tear of Thought established them as stars rather than just another pub rock band. Musically, the disc continues in the vein of hard rock established by their debut, although this time the band experiments with some new musical direction, including a jazz-influenced helping hand and a faithful cover of Boys Next Door classic Shivers. With enough raw power to delight fans and enough experimentation to keep critics happy, Tear of Thought was an enjoyable but ultimately disposable example of Australian hard rock music." So Helping Hand was track 6 on the album. It's written by Paul Woseen. The song was released in December 1993 as the fourth single from the album. The B-side was a live cover of the AC/DC song High Voltage and a live version of Shine On, also written by Paul Woseen. The single was produced by Steve James. The song peaked at number 25 on the ARIA Charts in January 2018 as part of Triple M's Ozzest 100, the most Australian songs of all time. Helping Hand was ranked number 56. The music video was filmed at Battersea Power Station, London, in the UK in 2012 on their first ever UK tour. Yeah, I've said it before, I don't know what they mean by most Australian song of all time. I don't know what the criteria to get into it. It's clearly not, I'm guessing you have to be an Australian band to get on, to qualify, but other than that, I don't think it has to be a song about Australian culture or necessarily anything to do with Australia. This song is, I would say, isn't an, well, it's not an Australian theme, it's just talking something about something that's universal. So anyway, I really enjoyed this. Screaming Jets are a band I've seen a number of times live, always great live, full of energy. They have a great time. They you know, get crowd interaction and the Screaming Jets gig is a good night. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did and you would like to support the channel, the best way you can do that is by liking, subscribing and commenting. It all helps, and I hope to see you on another video soon. Thanks for watching.